Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss angle measure. Let's start with an example. The question is to convert to radians, and in part A, we have 30 degrees. Let's work through it. Solution. So you start by writing down the 30 again. And to convert degrees to radians, you multiply by pi over 180, always. It's just pi over 180 times 30 degrees. And then 30 goes into 186 times. We end up with pi over 6. And this would be the radian measure of the angle. So 30 degrees is the same thing as pi over 6 radians. Let's do another one. So part B, we have 120 degrees. Solution. So same thing, you take the 120, and then you just always multiply it by pi over 180 in order to convert to radians every single time. So this might be a little bit harder to do in your head, but if you think about it, 60 goes into 120 twice, and 60 goes into 180 three times. So this ends up being 2 pi all over 3, and that would be your radian measure. So in order to convert degrees to radians, you always multiply by pi over 180. What if we had to go the other way? What if we were going from radians to degrees? Let's do some examples of that. So here is our next example. We have to convert to degrees, and part A is pi over 2. So this is given in radians. Solution. You start by writing down your angle, and then to convert to degrees, you basically multiply by 180 over pi. Basically, you have to get rid of the pi, loosely speaking, right? So it's always 180 over pi. These cancel, and then 2 goes into 180 90 times, so we end up with 90. And now it's really important to write the degree symbol here to indicate that it's degrees. Super, super key. Again, converting from radians to degrees, you just multiply by 180 over pi. Let's do one more. This one is a little bit harder, but it's not too bad. So we have 7 pi over 6, and we want to convert it to degrees. So solution. As before, we write 7 pi all over 6. And it's times 180 over pi. And we have some simplification here. The 6 goes into 180 30 times. And then the pi's cancel, so you're left with 7 times 30, which is 210. But we have to put the little degree symbol, super, super key, super important to include the degree symbol. So whenever you're converting from radians to degrees, you basically always just multiply by 180 over pi. And just to recap, whenever you're converting from degrees to radians, you multiply by pi over 180. Let's go ahead and do something a little bit different. In this last example, we are going to find two angles that are coterminal with 3 pi over 4. Let's go ahead and solve this solution. So two angles are coterminal if they differ by a multiple of 360. So let me explain what that means, or 2 pi. So here's 3 pi over 4 right here. Let me just show you what they are. So to find a coterminal angle, all you do is you add 2 pi or subtract 2 pi. And you can do it as many times as you like, as long as you end up in the same place. For example, if I add 2 pi to this, I guess I don't have to make it dotted, so I'll make it solid. I'm going to end up here, right? Same place. And if I add 2 pi again, end up in the same place. You can also subtract 2 pi. So you can add or subtract 2 pi as many times as you like to find coterminal angles. If you have degrees, then you do the same thing with 360. So let's just go ahead and find one. So it's 3 pi over 4 plus 2 pi. So to add these numbers, you basically need the second number, 2 pi, to be a number over 4. So you can do it in your head. You can just say, oh, 2 pi is the same as 8 pi over 4. That's what I usually do. But if you're not there yet, you can write it like this, 2 pi over 1, and then you can multiply by 4 over 4. That's 3 pi over 4 plus, and then 4 times 2 pi is 8 pi, and then 4 times 1 is 4. And now you have a common denominator, so you can add these. So 3 pi plus 8 pi is 11 pi. So that's going to be our first angle, our first answer. That's coterminal with 3 pi over 4. To find another one, we can just take 3 pi over 4 and subtract 2 pi, or we can just add 2 pi again to this one. Let's just add 2 pi again to this one. So we have 11 pi over 4 plus 2 pi. And again, we can write 2 pi as 8 pi over 4. So this is equal to 11 pi over 4 plus 8 pi over 4, because that's the same thing as 2 pi. And then you add the numerators because we have a common denominator. So 19 pi over 4. And there's infinitely many answers here, right? I could have added, you know, I could have subtracted 2 pi or subtracted, you know, 5 times 2 pi, because you can add and subtract 2 pi as many times as you like to get coterminal angles. So kind of an interesting problem. Hopefully you've learned some math in this video, and hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you have, make sure to check out Chegg for more videos. Until next time, good luck.